Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I.
I, Jason Srazin.
Joseph Colosimo.
Mike Plummer.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support, obey, and defend.
Support, obey, and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
Constitution of this Commonwealth.
And that I will discharge the duties.
I will discharge the duties.
As a Bridgeville Borough Councilman.
As a Bridgeville Borough Councilman.
With fidelity.
With fidelity.
Congratulations, gentlemen.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Congratulations.
One more.
Thank you very much, Justin.
You're very, very welcome.
Appreciate it.
Okay, well, have a good night. Happy New Year to you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If everyone would stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing to reflect on the sick, departed, and those providing military service. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Quorum is present, and as required of the mayor under section 1003 of the Pennsylvania Borough Code, I call to order this organizational meeting of Bridgeville Borough Council. Any members of the public wishing to speak? Seeing no members of the public wishing to speak, very briefly, government moves at a glacial pace, but it moves with great force. Plans to improve the north and south end of Washington Avenue are taking shape. We applied for a state grant to make significant improvements to McLaughlin Park in 2016. Bridgeville is financially stable, and our community is strong. As individuals, we should focus on the hard problems we face, not our petty differences. Together, we can use our government to improve our community. Every member of council cares about our community, so together with the members chosen to be president and vice president of council, we will lead this region and make Bridgeville even better. I open the floor to nominations for the president of council.
Mr. Mayor, I nominate Mike Plummer is president of council.
Thank you, Councilman Gallarducci. Any other nominations? Any other nominations? Any other nominations? Hearing no other nominations, Mike Plummer is elected president of council by acclamation. The floor is open for nominations for the vice president of council.
I nominate Bruce Gallarducci.
Any other nominations? Any other nominations? Any other nominations? Hearing no other nominations, Bruce Gallarducci is elected vice president of council by acclamation. Congratulations, Mr. Gallarducci and Mr. Tomer. I look forward to a productive future. Mr. President, the meeting is yours.
Thank you.
Board appointments. Vacant board and commission positions were advertised in the Tribune Review and the Bridgeville Area News on December 10th and 17th, 2015, with letters of interest received only from the current individual serving and Nino Petricelli Sr. Mr. Petricelli expressed interest to serve on any committee where his services may be needed. A motion of the Borough Council regarding the reappointment of John McCanns to a six-year term on the Civil Service Commission on the first Monday of January 2022. Oh, sorry, I misread that. Motion of the Borough Council regarding the reappointment of John McCanns to a six-year term on the Civil Service Commission on the first Monday of January 2022.
I'll make that motion.
All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? The motion is carried. Motion of the Borough Council regarding the reappointment of Joe Cower to a five-year term on the Planning Commission to the first Monday in January 2021. Mr. Cower has submitted a letter of interest to continue to serve. Jason? And Bruce? All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. A motion of the Borough Council regarding the reappointment of Bob Kelly to a five-year term on the Zoning Hearing Board to the first Monday in January 2021. Remarks also, Mr. Kelly has submitted a letter of interest to continue to serve.
I'll make a motion.
Bruce and Bill Calusi, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. A motion of the Borough Council regarding the reappointment of Joel Lakis to a two-year term on the Vacancy Board to the first Monday in January 2018. Also, Mr. Lakis has submitted a letter of interest to continue to serve. Bill Calusi?
Second.
And Neil Lyons. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion of the Borough Council regarding the appointment to the Zoning Hearing Board to the first Monday in January 2020. The appointment will serve the remaining term of Joe Colosimo due to his election to council. So, do we have any nominations for the open position in the Zoning Hearing Board? I know Mr. Petricelli said he would wish to do that.
Well, I'm not going to nominate Petricelli for that.
Okay, thank you, Joe. Any second?
I'll second.
All right, Bill Henderson. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Appointment of the Borough's solicitor. A motion of the Borough Council appointing Titans to Syria Nicholas PC as the Borough Legal Consultants for the calendar year 2016. Jason and Bruce, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you for my time.
What's that?
Thank you, it's my privilege to serve.
Well, thank you, you're welcome. Thank you very much for serving.
No.
Check the mail.
Yeah. I had an opposition to that.
What's that?
One on record.
Opposed. Okay.
Do a roll call in or?
Do we need a roll call?
6-1.
It's just 6-1.
Appointment of the Borough Engineer. A motion of the Borough Council appointing the Gateway Engineers Incorporated as the consulting engineers for the calendar year 2016.
Make a motion.
Jason?
Second.
And Joe Colosimo. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Joe. Regarding the visitors. List of bills. A motion of the Borough Council approving the December 2015 final bill list.
So moved. Second.
Bruce and Bill Henderson. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion of the Borough Council approving the January 2016 bill list.
So moved.
Phil Henderson and Jason. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Payrolls. Motion the Borough Council approving the payrolls of January 8, 15, 22, 29, and February 5, 2016.
So moved.
Bruce and Joe Colosimo. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Monthly reports. A motion to accept and pay any commissions due the December 2015 real estate tax collector report.
So moved.
Bruce and Jason, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Committee reports. Administration. That's you.
No report, sir.
Finance.
Yeah, we're here.
We don't have a finance.
Right.
Committee chairman yet.
Right, as far as you can do the reorganization of the committees during the month and then submit them to the council.
As far as, what's that, Parks and Recreation?
No report.
No report, all right. Public Works?
No report.
And Public Safety, Phil?
No report.
Nice and, I'm gonna get dinner tonight. Mr. Mayor?
Earlier, in December, there was an armed robbery at Kogo's. And I wanted to compliment our police department for identifying and seeing that the perpetrator, that the alleged perpetrator was apprehended. Their efforts were simply good police work, which I've found is a lot more work than you might think. So, thank you to the officers for a team and for an excellent job, and I very much appreciate their service to our community.
Good job.
Police Chief?
Thank you, Council President. Just to elaborate a bit more on that robbery in particular, it happened on a Thursday night. We developed a suspect, a short list of suspects within a matter of hours, just from the officer's familiarity with people in the community. And we quickly dissolved that down to one individual we focused on. On Friday, which was the following day, we hit his house with a search warrant, his apartment with a search warrant. On Saturday, we had the arrest warrant. And Sunday, the individual was located in Florida, which is where he was taken into custody. So it was good police work, and it was an example of the officers knowing the community, knowing individuals in this town, because although we had video of the robbery, it was very hard to put a face to who that person was. We had to go off the clothing description more so than anything, so it was a very unique jacket the individual was wearing. But I had a couple officers and individuals that looked at it and said, it could be so-and-so, and sure enough, that's who it was. So he'll have his day in court, but he gave a confession to the officers in Florida, so it's pretty much looking like a good case for us, and brought a resolution to it. But it's not his first brush with the law either, so hopefully, maybe it's his last. Yes, he was local, living in Bridgeville Towers. We arrested him. Our first arrest we could attribute to Facebook for solving for us was last June, and it was this individual. We walked into the beer warehouse, stole a case of beer, and walked out with it. So if you remember seeing that, that's who it was. So it's unfortunate he has an addiction to alcohol, and that's probably the driving factor behind the crime itself, but it's solved. Nobody was hurt. So that's all I have.
Thank you, Chief. Solicitor, Tom McDermott.
I don't have any thing to report. I would ask for a brief executive session with you on the litigation.
Engineer, Mr. Sykes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Not too much new since the middle of December. Just want to give you a couple updates with regards to the Washington Avenue water main replacement. Since I wrote this report, I did talk with the contractor today who was a successful low bidder. And they will be getting in contact with Lori and myself, have a pre-construction meeting to get that job moving here probably before the end of the month or early February. So maybe the water line. But in conjunction with that, we're preparing specifications and plans to do the sanitary sewer main repairs that are required on the main line through there. And we'll get those done in conjunction with that. And then Lori and I have a meeting on Thursday with PennDOT to update, or I guess they're giving us the final presentation of the South Hills Comprehensive Traffic Study. This was implemented about a year ago, and hopefully there'll be some information that we can review and include with the Route 50 Task Force.
Great.
So that's all.
Very much.
Yes.
The walk and run repaving.
Oh, that's, yeah, Bruce, that's what I brought that up. That's another thing we're looking at, the sanitary sewers there. And I don't have a timeframe for when PennDOT's going to be doing that work, but the work that we're going to do with the sanitary sewers there can be mostly liners.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that, if we could look at, I don't know what the issue with sidewalks.
We can look at the sidewalk, sure. Let's go look at that and see what the ordinance states regarding the curb and sidewalks. Responsibility along the cooperative.
I found this keeps my stress.
We can work on something with property owners and notify them of what's coming about. And
sure.
See who would be interested in. This is the time to do it.
Yeah.
Another question.
Yes, Joel.
You said that's on Washington Avenue?
Washington. Yes.
And is that going down the middle, or is it on the right or left hand side?
I don't have a definite location as to where they're going to put the new main line. I know that when we met with Pennsylvania American Water, they said they wanted to upgrade the size of it.
Right.
It's a big line, right?
It's a decent line going down there now.
Yeah, they want to make it larger, going from basically St. Clair Street all the way out to Chartier Street.
Okay, when are they going to do the work?
Probably February. Okay. And I think they said that the contract signed by the end of the month, and they got to order pipe and then get going with it.
I can't believe they wanted to listen to do that.
Well.
Joe, who's the contractor one that did?
Paul Seamount.
Is that night work, Joe?
I'm thinking it might end up being night work. But I think that's what they might have told us.
Yeah.
I think when we have the pre-construction meeting, we'll have yourself and Chad present at the pre-construction meeting. I think they may want to be employing off-duty officers for traffic control.
Okay. When are they looking to start that, Joe?
Probably end of the month, early February. Maybe a little bit longer.
Sounds good.
Thank you. Fire Chief.
While we're on it, there is an intermodal transportation grant. I think we're.
We applied.
Did you apply for it?
Yeah, we did apply for it.
What was
that? For Chartier Street for $500,000.
Okay, so that's what we put for the intermodal.
December 18th of this year.
Okay. Well, there's one.
Is this the same one we got turned down, or is this we applying a different grant with the city?
This is a different grant.
The one in December, wasn't that Green Light Go?
No.
That was Intermodal?
Green Light Go hasn't been awarded yet from last year because there's no budget.
Okay.
Intermodal was due December 18th and we applied for it.
Okay.
And then we heard about the parks, but then we were turned down for the CTF grant.
Right.
For Chartier Street.
Okay.
But the intermodal is.
Was applied for.
Yes.
December 18th.
Okay,
yeah, it's a due date.
Great. Thank you.
Fire Chief Bill Chilio.
Thanks, Mr. President. You'll have my report next month on calls and that with the holidays and that, and meeting this early in the year for the month. Guys aren't done getting the reports in for totally last year. I do know we did about 185 to 190 calls last year we handled. So last month we've been very busy, which Bruce probably knows that. We've had a couple good fires. We assisted on Christmas Eve within one in Scott Township. So that's it.
Thank you. Dan's not here from Southbridge. Becky's not here from the library. And Sparrow Manager, Lori.
I have a few quick things. I just wanted to let you know that I talked to Vice President of Municipal Services for PNC Bank today. And he was just giving me an update on the bank. They will be moving probably by April.
What are you moving?
What they're doing is they're moving the services from that bank up to the Collier Township office. And he said the reason that they're doing that is since all of the electronic devices, as far as, we had a long conversation about, you know, taking a picture of your checks and the direct deposits and those type things, and there isn't a drive-up ATM at that, at that service, so they just don't get the foot traffic in there to accommodate the employees that they have to keep in there. So probably about opening moving.
Any rumors on who wants to go in there?
I haven't heard anything as of yet.
I'm sure there'll be a million rumors in 2 weeks.
Sure.
Let's start one.
And as far as the neighborhood study reports that Carolyn gave us that they do authorize last year, she had given me a couple dates at the end of December, but I was on vacation, either the 12th or the 14th, which is pretty
this month?
Close. If you want to make it later in the month, I emailed her and asked her for some other dates. And what this is going over those plans, answering questions, and would also like the Planning Commission to come if they're interested also. So what I'll do, I hadn't heard back from her today, so I'll get some dates from her. I will email or call and see what's good for everybody, and then it's going to be an information meeting with those two studies. And then we're just closing up the year of opening up the new year. I just want to wish everybody a happy new year and congratulations to the really lovely council.
Thank you. Old business.
I have something.
Yes, sir.
Couple things. First is looking at the garbage service. We looked at the time Bill brought up about doing internally the garbage cells. And also, it's not fancy what they did if they turned around and changed the garbage to the village. And you know, we're always looking out for the best interest of Bridgeville and see what works best for us. And sometimes we have to take a look and see, is it best what we're doing, or is it best moving forward to the next step? So with that in mind, I'd like to take a look and see if in the future we can take a look and see who the manager help and some people to finance, if even possible. I mean, this, we may be doing the best we can with what we have, but there may be another option out there that we could maybe take a look at and see. If you save people, you know, taxpayers' money, and then I don't know if you can move forward.
You know, I mean, obviously there's pros and cons of
there's
how to do it.
And we can give you the pros, because there are pros, and we can give you the cons and costs and those types of things. So
enough information, we can take a look at it and say that this could work the best.
Sure.
Okay. Council, Mr. Resnick, we can fold that into, council already has us looking for next year's budget cycle at alternatives in terms of in-house or intermunicipal agreement or those kinds of alternatives, and we can fold that into the same process.
Great. All right. New business. And new business. As our solicitor mentioned earlier, he wanted to go break out for an executive session, more of an information thing for us. No action required, so I think we're going to look for a motion to adjourn.
Second,
all those in favor?
Aye.
Happy New Year, everybody.